Hey guys, welcome back to Castlevania, Circle of the Moon. In the last part, we weren't right all the way down here. We were up there in the other upper level places. But there's areas down here that need to be explored, so I'm going to do that. So, ow. Freaking Hopper, die. So, oh, I hate how they're just short enough to go underneath your whip. So yeah, you need the double jump to get up here, so... Yeah. Oh, okay, there's brain floats up there. Oh, oh, there we go. And a little... Oh, crap, no! No, freaking Hopper, go away! Good. I was about to say, don't you dare make me lose that. Now, that's one thing that's worth noting. If you ever lose a weapon, you can always get it again in the exact same spot that you found it. Oh, oops. Hang on. Oh my god, I hate these hoppers. They're so annoying. Let's see. Is it back? Okay, good, it is. Okay. Ice powers activate! Okay. And there we go. Pink lemonade! Sweet. So if you can ride the brain floats, you can get some... You can get some pink lemonade and an MP max. So this is very worth coming back to do. And all you need is the double jump, so, yeah. I guess I can just cut to when I find something that's that needs to be explored, so, yeah. I think I might just do that. Let's see. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna cut around, so I'll see you when I find something that needs to be explored. Or, you know, whatever. Okay, so here's an area I hadn't gone to. It's up here. So, yeah, or, you know, down there, up here, whatever. Oh, hey, cool. I knew there was a block that I had to break down here. And whoa, stone armor. And he throws rocks. Nice. Good toss. Ow! Crap, did he stone me? No. Aha! Sucker. Okay. Now, let's see. Oh. Thriller zombies or something. God, I love boomerangs. They're so good. Okay. Haha. And MP max. Anything back here? No. Okay. So that's that room explored. I guess now I'll just go check and... I guess I'll just look around here some more. So, yeah. Okay, so now we're further back up in the castle, and I know where I'm going. So, let's get back to it. So, I believe we're... See? Frickin' skeleton. I believe where we need to go next is this. Because we gotta use that to get through. So, yeah. Now we got a long way to go. Because we gotta... This is a very long hallway to get to where we're going. And then, where we're going should chill the blood of every Castlevania fan in existence. You'll see what I mean soon enough. These zombie thieves, I believe they drop a good item, so you might consider killing a few of them. So, yeah. Come on, get out of here. Friggin' ectoplasm. Aren't you just an item that the ghosts and wraiths drop in, Oblivion? Okay, so, let's see, what's this way? I don't believe this is actually where I need to go. I think this is for an item, but let's see. Ah, yeah, it is. Okay, that'll be for later. Okay. And I'm progressing really fast. I didn't think I'd go this fast, but hey, I guess there's nothing wrong with that. That and it's a Game Boy Advance game, so obviously it's not going to be too terribly long. Like, even the Pokemon games aren't that long if you know what to do. Machine Tower, or the Clock Tower. So yeah, you should be scared. Oh, Fox Archer. Is that a Disney reference? A Disney reference in a Castlevania game. Awesome. Come on. Oh, Medusas, no. Medusa heads, they suck. Okay. So we got awesome music here, but... We got Medusa heads and moving platforms and archers. That's not awesome. Boom. Okay. So we got a heart upgrade up here, so this is worth getting, obviously. Haha. That's another reason why this thing is so useful, because you can kill enemies without having to get right next to them. Okay. So let's see. God, the music here actually is really cool. And here's a save point, just so, you know, you don't die. Because this place, this can be hard. Not gonna lie, this actually is a tough area. If only because the platforming can get very annoying, because, you know, you get, when you get hit, you know, you get knocked back and stuff, so you don't want to get hit. Ooh, silk robe. Let's see that. Probably, oh yeah, it gives me a lot of intelligence, but takes away a lot of, takes away 10 defense. So yeah, if you use a lot of magic, that's actually worth getting. And that actually kind of brings me to a different thing in this game. You noticed how at the very, very beginning I was able to name myself, and I just named myself Boo. You can actually... Ooh, the pocket watch, but I'm not going to get that. Oh, geez, I'm stoned. Right. When the Medusa heads touch you, you get stoned, and you got to move all around to break it. So, yeah. Ow, the hell. Something interesting about the game. You notice how I named myself Boo. If you name yourself different things, you can actually play a different way. Ooh, health upgrade. So, for example, you know how you do magic by having all these cards and stuff? If you play through the game and you beat it on Vampire Killer, the current, you know, mode that I'm going through right now, where you just have the whip and you're like a standard melee fighter, if you beat it on this mode, and then on a second playthrough, you name yourself Fireball, you actually start out with every magic card. So, yeah, you can kind of play through as a caster if you want, and you have, like, lower strength, you have lower, like, defense and stuff like that, and so you're kind of forced to use magic. So, that's kind of an interesting way to make it so you can play the game a different way, is, like, literally change your stats around and stuff like that. The only issue I have with that is just that it's an unlockable. I kind of wish that that was just a way you could choose. It's like, do you want to play as a caster? Or do you want to play as a regular guy? You know what I mean? It'd be cool if you could just choose that right from the get-go, but whatever. Ah! Crap! Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Get out. Okay. Yeah, that's what makes this place really annoying, just the fact that the Medusa heads knock you off platforms and they stone you. Okay. Haha! Super sneaky. Or not really sneaky. Oh god, oh! At least they're really weak and they don't do much damage. And you can kill them in one hit. That's also good. Good. I didn't think that was going to hit him, but it did. But if you come up here, boom! Oh, crap. Oh, wait a minute. These enemies drop a card. Rah! That's actually kind of creepy, that little scream that they do. Ugh. But, you want to fight these heat shades. Oh, jeez. Thing is, like, semi-guided. But yeah, I seem to remember them dropping cards. Or a card, you know what I mean? Let's see, I'm gonna kill her just a few more times. Actually, you know what? I'm just gonna cut until I get it, so hang on. Okay, I've killed her a good, like, 20 times or so. Oh, crap. Oh, thank God. I killed her a good 20 times. I didn't get anything. I'm just gonna assume that she doesn't drop a card. So, yeah. Maybe I was wrong in remembering that. Maybe it's a different shade. I do remember that there's an enemy in here that drops a card. So... No, I remember it being this enemy. I just got unlucky, but whatever. I can always just come back here and grind off-screen if I want, and if people are actually playing this game along with me, which I kind of doubt, you can just look up a guide. So yeah, there are guides that show every enemy and the best place. Like, they show what enemies drop cards, and they also tell you the best place to get the enemy, you know what I mean? Like, to the best place to fight it repeatedly and quickly enough to actually get it. But without driving yourself crazy, that is. Okay. Not at the top yet, though. What the hell? How did that happen? Didn't I kick him? That was weird. Yeah. I guess he just hit me right before I could. Oh, no. No. Okay, I can't get up there. Okay. So, where to? Oh, just up. Okay, that works. Of course, you always gotta go up in these friggin' towers. You know, I don't think there's ever been a tower in a game. Oh, actually, no. Okay, I stand corrected just even before I finish that sentence. I was gonna say that I don't think there's a tower in a video game that you go down. But yeah, there is. There's a part in Tales of Symphonia where you have to go down the Tower of Salvation. Okay, never mind. Of course it's from Symphonia. Everything is in Symphonia. Okay. Oh geez, got like Tesla coils there. So don't touch those. Oh good, thank God. Cause I was getting my ass beat. Okay, thankfully I haven't died yet though. Die. Oh, let me guess, he's back, isn't he? Good. Because if you walk far enough away from an enemy, they do respawn, so that can be very annoying. That's not what I wanted to happen, but whatever. Come down here. Is there anything down here aside from you? It doesn't look like there's much down here. Now this. That guy, I know for a fact, he drops a thing. A card. Ah, stop with the light. Would you get down here? Dude. Thank you. I can't even... Like, I don't mind fighting you, but put him in a place where I can actually read. Oh my god. This place is horrible for this fight. Wow, dude. There we go. See, you can destroy him if you can get a hit, and he doesn't fly up near the ceiling. Boom. No. Give me my pink lemonade. Aw, yeah. Ow, ow. Man. So yeah, he'll call down like 3 lightning bolts. What are you doing? God, so deadly. Ow, what? Ugh. Die. These guys are annoying. Ow, oh my god. Just hitting me and hitting me. Get down here and stop flying around so much. There we go, eat it. Ooh, what's that? Hey, a magic gauntlet. What does that do? No, not that. Magic gauntlet. Oh, it gives me intelligence. Boo. It takes away attack, so I don't really care. Because I don't use magic that much. Okay, what's down here? Because obviously I gotta get out of this place. Oh, another one? Okay. Oh, come on! Sit your ass still! There, die. It's boomerangs, man. So OP. But I don't care. Holy water. Ain't nothing there. Alright, let's get out of here. I've had enough of these friggin' thunder demons kicking my ass. What's this? Like an item? Oh. What is this? Oh, yeah, it is. Just gotta watch out for the stone armor. Oh, hey. Hard ring. Cool. Max HP. My pink lemonade. Hard ring. Defense increases. Oh, but I lose HP and luck. I mean, strength and luck. Jeez. It's a lot of HP. It's a lot of defense, though. You can't really drop items, but hey. Now I have that. Oh, crap. Boom. You see that? That was a... Oh, my God. I just destroyed him. Come on. There we go. That was a perfect hit with the boomerang. I got like 5 hits. So, yeah. That's what you want to try to go for when you use the boomerang. That, like, perfect hit. And, yeah, I realize that much of this Let's Play has been me just backtracking and getting items and stuff. But, you know, it's Metroidvania. Come on. Gotta do it. Because I think it's fun. I like this kind of... I like this kind of Castlevania game. I'm sure some people don't. I'm sure most people, or maybe not most, but I'm sure some people prefer the old games. And that's understandable. but I personally like these the most. Ah. I never thought Disney would be kicking my ass. Come on. Break it. That's why you shouldn't do drugs, because when you get stoned, you literally turn to stone. And it's very inconvenient when you have to, you know, start moving again, because you're a rock. Oh, crap. Okay, so what's over there exactly? Anything? Oh, okay, so it's just this. Ow! Oh, screw you! Friggin' heat spirit thingy. Die. Okay, well, at least I'm still on the platform. That's all I care about. Haha! Sucker. Oh, what the hell, man? That one was... That's totally out of sync. Oh! Ugh! Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. Come on. Why is it... That seems really stupid, like... Yeah, but there's something up there. I know it. Ugh! Oh, hey, I could technically freeze the Medusas. Let's see. Is that thing ever going to be in sync with this one or not? Come on. Oh, crap, it is. No. Oh, I hate you, Medusa heads. You bitches. Okay, so I'm going to end it here. And next time, we're actually going to make that jump and get over there. So see you guys then.